Well, hey friends, good morning. It's Rhonda. I'm back feeling a little better this week than I did last week, which is pretty awesome. I'm happy about that. So I wanted to talk to you today about a few tricks and tips to help you get a little bit more efficient in your office, especially if you are a one-man or one-woman show. What happens when we run a business is that the part of being a practitioner is comes easy for us. It's easy. We can roll in, help the patient. It's all the other back end stuff that gets overwhelming. It's the ordering and the paying of the bills and the, you know, how you're gonna handle your marketing. It's all that other stuff that starts to get really overwhelming. But there's a very easy way for you to leverage some time and get a little bit of freedom back and be able to provide better customer experience and make yourself so that you're not up at night thinking about, oh my gosh, what do I need to do next? So here's what I suggest to all the practitioners that I work with. There's a few exceptions, but in general, this works really well. Find a virtual assistant for 5 hours a week. So let's break this down. If you're open, if your clinic is open 5 days a week, okay, you're 5 days a week. If your clinic's open 5 days a week, then you can hire someone to work 1 hour each day to place the orders, to follow up with the patients on anything that they need. Like, let's say during the consult, you know, in your notes, you wrote that you wanted to send them a resource on SIBO or a resource on, you know, some other digestive issue or a thyroid issue or whatever it might be. So you put your system together so that your virtual assistant knows exactly what they need to do and what needs to be sent. You do some training videos on how to go order on standard process. You double check it in the morning to make sure that everything looks good and there's no monkey business. My experience with VAs, they don't monkey around. They're in, they get the job done, and they're done. So you can have them place orders. You can have them email anything to the patient. You can have them follow up with certain like inquiries, people wanting to schedule, that kind of thing. And you only have to pay them for an hour a day. That's 5 hours a week, and that's all. Now think about how much time that would free up for you. Well, at minimum, 5 hours. Because what happens is for us is we get distracted. So let's say you promised a patient some digestive resources. Well, you start typing out the email and then you remember, oh yeah, I was supposed to follow up on that other email. So you minimize the first email, you go find the other email, and now we're off chasing the sparkly, shiny objects, right? So that's what we don't want to do. What we want to do is you and I as business owners, we want to stay focused on what's important and let the stuff that someone else can do, and I know you may not want to have someone else have that kind of access, but if you're going to grow, at some point, you have to give up that kind of control. Now, if you already have team members, you already have staff, there will still be ways that you as the business owner can outsource some of your tasks. For instance, you might be doing all of your accounting. We'll find a bookkeeper. And think about how much less stress that will have. That was a huge one for me. At one time, when I had I was full-time in practice, seeing people 5 days a week, I was extremely busy. We were ordering about $8,000 wholesale each week from Standard Process. So we were cranking through the supplements. And so our invoices and what we owed and the payables and the receivables and the deposits and all that, it was our bank statements and credit card statements were huge. And at one point during that busy period of time, I was so busy that I just didn't balance my bank statements for 14 months was the longest that it went. And the only reason I had to do it was because I had to file my taxes. And the thought now still, it just makes me shiver. But what the thought of going back and having to do all of that all over again, I saw charges on there that weren't mine. My account got hacked in the middle and I lost about $300 and had I been on top of it, I would have picked that up and went, hey, that's not my charge. I wasn't in Timbuktu, you know, Indiana. I don't know about that. So I lost a bunch of money, and it just cost me money to not do it. But I was so busy. That's the one task I should have outsourced. I should have found a bookkeeper and said, here are the charges that you can expect to see. These are the expense or the income accounts they need to go to. Anything outside of that that is not posted, send to me in an Excel spreadsheet and I will tell you where it goes, and then you can finish. And that's what I would have done. Now, that's what I have now. That's my situation now. And oh my gosh, I can't tell you. Oh, I feel so much better knowing that I don't have to watch over that. I still have to supervise, manage, and make sure that everything's taken care of, but I don't have to watch that box. In other words, the money accounting box. I don't have to keep an eye on it because someone else is doing the work. So there are still ways that you can outsource what you're doing as a business owner to leverage and free up your time. So don't think that just because, you know, if you say, I can't hire a virtual assistant, yes, you can. It may only be for 5 hours a week or 3 hours a week. There's no rule about it. You can also look for, if you don't need someone who's going to be, you know, doing a lot of emails or anything like that, you can find people like in the Philippines that will do the work for much less than you can find in the US. And they do a really good job because they're primarily English speaking. They don't know syntax all the time, so sometimes like if you know they won't know our, I don't want to say syntax, but like our culture and the things that we say and you know the little innuendos types of thing, they won't know those. But I've had great success using workers from the Philippines. So that's an option for you as well. So you got lots of options. Here in the US, I would check Fiverr, Fiverr, and Upwork, Upwork, Fiverr and Upwork. Those are two great options for you. And then in the Philippines, it's onlinejobs.ph. And there are several others that also offer, you know, outsourcing in other countries. So those are your options, but I highly encourage you, if you're feeling stressed, you're feeling overwhelmed, if the whole business thing just has you like all pinched up and wadded up in a bundle, it might be time for you to let go of the control reins. I know it's hard. I know. But it's if you're especially if you're by yourself, you've got control over everything. It's time. If you want to grow, you've got to let go. And that's how we start to leverage and get even better and grow our practices and have them work the way that we want them to. So, that's it for today. I've got a few more things that I want to share with you. Later this week, I'll be in the Grow Your Wellness Business Facebook group and then also on Instagram, and I'm around. So you can always message me, DM me if you have any questions, or go to the Facebook group. I'd love to have you join me there. All right, you guys, take care. Have an awesome week. Thanks for being part of my tribe. Mwah. See you later.